that if we don't, this gig could be up within 20 years. Now, I was reading a Daphne Rose Kingma book, another wonderful woman who writes wonderful books, and she said something in one of her books that really stayed with me. She said, she was talking about what makes a chicken know when it's time to start pecking its way out of the eggshell. Yeah, I had never thought about this. The way a chicken knows it's time to start pecking its way out of the egg is because when it is time for the chicken to be born into the world, a noxious gas fills the inside of the egg. It is literally dying to be born. Wow. It starts pecking its way out because if I stay in here, I will die. We're a parliament of religions. Are we going to just sit here and talk to each other about what we already know? Religion has a lot of explaining to do on this planet. What we need to do is to go out there. And those of us who are Christians say, well, I know Christianity got some stuff wrong. Let me show you how gorgeous it can be. For those of us who are Muslims who say, I know some Muslims have gotten some of it wrong. Let me show you how gorgeous this can be. For those of us who are Jewish, to say, I know sometimes some of us get some of it wrong. Let me show you how gorgeous this can be. For those who are Buddhist, to say, well, I don't think they ever get it wrong. Don't show the world how gorgeous it can be. And so forth, and so forth, and so forth. You know, when I was a little girl, my mother was a very traditional housewife. She lived for my father, who she was madly in love with. She lived for her children. She lived for at home. And when I was growing up, I thought my mother's life was not important enough. I wanted to go out into the world and do great things. First of all, once you learn metaphysics, you know there is no out there. But I also, it took me decades to know how wrong I was about my mother's life. I went out there and read about the divine feminine on the planet, and I realized my mother was the one living the divine feminine, because the divine feminine fiercely protects the children and protects the home. So my mother had it right. It's just that we've evolved to the point of knowing every child on this planet is one of our children, and the earth itself is our home.
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
So we'll have a couple minutes of silence together, but then there is also the grieving, which is part of the Via Negativa. And of course, today's world has a lot to grieve about. The very theme of this conference about sustainability and the eco crisis and all the rest is something to grieve about. So we are going to do a grieving practice together. I'm convinced that our species needs to learn anew how to grieve together. Because if we cannot grieve together, it's like a boulder in our hearts, and our creativity gets blocked up. And the creativity of our species is really the only thing we have going for us. So we've got to do some breathing together. So we will do that practice, and I'll explain what we do at that time of our prayer together.
Spirit of the West.
Spirit of the West.
We welcome you.
We welcome you.
So we welcome in the darkness, which feeds us so well. Spirit of the North.
Spirit of the North.
We welcome you.
We welcome you.
We thank you for your gifts.
We thank you for your gifts.
Now relax the center and look. Spirit of the Sky.
Spirit of the Sky,
we welcome you.
We welcome you.
We thank you for your gifts.
We thank you for your gifts.
Down below is holiness of this earth. Spirit of the Earth.
Spirit of the Earth.
Uniting all life together. Spirit of the heart.
Spirit of the heart.